this section of the video, we're going to be working with the expanding sphere as a moving practice, learning to add in the weight shift and the waist turn as part of the expanding sphere. So here we want to be shoulder width or slightly wider with our feet. And when you begin, a lot of people really like to start at shoulder width or just a little bit wider. But as you go along and you want to develop more leg strength, it's often helpful to widen the stance. It lets you work deeper into the ball and socket joints of the hips and develop more and more strength and flexibility in the lower body. But again, it is not necessary. Working at this position is just fine. And I'll start here. And some classes or some video classes you're going to see I will be wider. In other ones, I'll be here. So we're going to start with the sense of the weight shift and waist turn. Now we want to coordinate the two things we've worked on. When I weight shift, I want to shift and turn towards the leg. Again, this leg stays open and relaxed. I want to move into the triangle of the foot that I'm moving towards, making sure I'm always in the center. One of the things that's a common error that people make is they roll to the outside, their foot lifts up, and they begin to put a lot of tension along the IT band and into the side of the knee. Another common mistake that people make is they'll shift and turn, and when they do, they'll collapse the leg that they're leaving, allowing this leg to just lose its vitality, lose its action. In order to be in proper structure for Tai Chi, we want both legs to be active and engaged, alive and lively, right? Okay, so we start with the center. We shift and turn, becoming receptive and expressive or expansive on each side, and then shift and turn to the other side. Now we want a sense of the center and center line making that turn back and forth. And it's about a 90 degree angle from one side to the other that you want to make, or at least shoot for that. You can certainly go wider, and the wider your legs go, the wider that angle will change. Okay? But at the sort of natural position, shoulder width or slightly wider, it generally is about a 90 degree angle. Okay? Now that's the lower body. And again, in this lower body movement, I'm always wanting to pay attention to the sense of receiving in one leg and expanding through the other simultaneously. When we keep that in line and in our awareness with the sense of the right and left channels, we begin to connect to something called coiling, which is what this exercise is slowly building us towards. Okay? So we're going to start first with this exercise doing one hand. We're going to start with our hand in front of the body. We're going to shift to the opposite side. And as I do so, I'm going to inhale and begin to expand. And then as I exhale, I'm going to bring my hand out and bring it back in. So here I'm really just looking for a sense of the expanding sphere. My hand is not going to do much turning yet. I'm just getting a sense of expand and return. Of practicing, I may discover that I'm having difficulty with either the weight shift or the waist turn. So I will separate them. And so I practice sometime with just the weight shift. Sometimes I will practice with just the waist turn. even on just a waist turn, there's always the sense of one leg pressing into the ground and the other leg receiving as I turn. Because when I turn, the power changes. It moves down in one leg and up in the other. A sense of receiving and exchanging. This is always an exchange of energy from one side to the other as things change in relationship to each other. Now, there's a couple of very important elements here in this. One of the things in terms of Tai Chi that I see a lot when I teach is that people will move their arms a lot more than they need to. Now, when I'm doing the weight shift and just no waist turn, I'm just expanding to the side, I actually make a much larger circle. But when I'm doing the waist turn, either just the waist turn by itself or the weight shift and waist turn, my hand is going to stay a lot closer to my body. I'm really wanting to keep it within the sphere of the immediate space, because then when I turn, I've still got all of this. If my hands are connected to the middle dantian and I rotate, then they're rotating over here, still able to go to the sides of the body, but this right hand then gets way over here. And then if I bring it from the center line to here, this is what the right hand covers, is this space here. When I go this way, it comes all the way over here. So now it looks like my hand covers a lot of distance. But if you look, my hand really only goes from here to here. So if I turn to the front, you can see the hand is just there along the side of the body. This is an important element. There's an illusion of a lot of movement in the arms in Tai Chi. And so people tend to emulate it with a lot, way too much arm movement. So I want you to try to keep that in mind, that your arms want to stay close. We don't want to be too close. We are going to reach out and expand some. But we never want to be reaching with our bodies. Another element of that mistake that I see people make is they'll reach so far and they'll pull themselves over. Now their structure's really destroyed, because you're not in the triangle of the foot when you're like that. You're leaning, you've got a lot of tension all through here, and you're reaching too far. Your whole center line is out of balance. Okay? Again, we're trying to get a sense of an even sphere where power flows in and out through, but within it. Okay? All right. We're going to use the other hand and do the same thing. We'll start with just the expanding to the side first, doing the just weight shift. Inhale, expand. So those are those two basics. Now we're going to put them together and get the weight shift and waist turn. So that's when we come up. So now, that was a one-handed weight shift and waist turn. Next we're going to do two hands. We're going to put both of those together. Again, we're not getting any of the coiling actions in yet. We're still just expanding. The arm is kind of staying in its neutral position. We're not working with that spiral of the right and left channels. That's coming in the next practice, which is called coiling. So again, the tongue lightly touches the roof of the mouth. Breath will move in and out through the nose, down through the center, all the way to the center, or down the center line, all the way to the center, or the lower dantian. A a sense of expansion to the front and back, and it'll be coordinated with our movements. So the alternating, using both hands, is we might start with one side. As it comes up, when that one gets here, the other one is going to be at the bottom, like so. So we inhale and expand. Exhale and return with that hand while filling the other side. Now, coordination with breath. You can either do as we've been doing, where we inhale and exhale. You're just focusing one hand coordinating the inhale. Or you can inhale through both movements. So you can inhale and then exhale. Ultimately, it is up to you what works most naturally. All of this must be coordinated with a natural breath, and you will find at different times your practice will require you to be in a different breathing pattern. Sometimes you'll need to breathe with only one arm, inhale in the expansion and exhale in the return. Sometimes your breath will be very deep and very slow, and your movements will be either slower or faster, and it'll coordinate better that you'll have an inhale on both. All you're trying for is a rhythmic, balanced, even breath. Tongue lightly touches the roof of the mouth, and we begin. That's your very basic moving expanding sphere, or what we call circling. Next, we'll work on coiling.